Hello, hello, Crypto Hopper fans. If you're a Crypto Hopper fan, if you're watching this video, you're probably a Wayman Media Limited fan or also a Crypto Hopper fan. We've been doing a couple of reviews on this Crypto Hopper. So this is our tips and tricks. We'll be doing Crypto Hopper tips and tricks. So yeah, stay tuned. Right, so what is Crypto Hopper? Let's just this is a short video. We don't wanna do 1 hour videos. We're gonna open the hopper on this one. This is just tips and tricks, right? So it's just a series on its own that's going to continue. But because we are still on the beginning, we'll be doing like a few of them, maybe once a month or so. So because this is information that I've received from a couple of Crypto Hopper users collectively, and then I put together to essentially broadcast and help other Crypto Hopper, maybe beginners or people who want to join in and try out the Crypto Hopper bots. One of the other reasons is that I get a lot of requests on explaining how this works and stuff. So I also have more than 200 referrals. Sign-ups on my link. So if you're watching this, you probably also signed up on my link, or if you don't, then it's fine, but it also works getting people to sign up on your link. So let's just jump straight into it to make it short. What is Crypto Hopper? Crypto Hopper is the leaders. This is the leader in the automated crypto industry. So right now, currently, this is this Crypto Hopper is the leader in this industry. So what does it do? It allows traders to automate trading strategies. So if you're using this Crypto Hopper, it will allow you, if you are a trader, I mean, if you are the user of the software, you can automate your trading. So your trading can be like completely automated. There's no man involvement whatsoever. So users of this software can only trade in cryptocurrency like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and many others. Like all of the cryptocurrencies, you are exposed to them. But it's only cryptocurrency. It doesn't do forex or anything, stocks, no. So it also depends on the exchange, which cryptocurrencies they hold. Right. So what does the Crypto Hopper do? So the Crypto Hopper scans the market 24/7. So it's like day and night. It's always scanning the market. And then after scanning the market, it opens positions according to your trading strategy or signalers, if you are getting signals. So the hopper will be trading those signals and placing those trades according to those signals. Right, so the Crypto Hopper scans for the lowest prices and sells when trades move into good profits or continue to hold great profits or the best profits possible. So already you can see that this is doing almost everything for you. 24/7 is trading, scanning the market, strategies, looking for the lowest prices and then selling at the highest ones, you know. So you are probably asking yourself how you would be getting started with this. So getting started with Crypto Hopper is easy. You just register your account using only your username, email, password, and address, obviously. And then you get to verify your email address like any other platform for security, and then I mean just for verification that you really own the email. And then within this particular minute, then within a minute you already set up. So then already the setup, your account setup comes with the simulator bot which you can use for practice, which will take you 7 days so to use for free. So you get to get like some exposure before you even think of working with this bot. So this bot has been around since 2017. So yeah, and the users, everything, there is they have other social media communities like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, yeah. So there is a quick tour for beginners. When you are still new, they give you a quick tour with videos, and then there's also interactive support. There's just a green icon there on the right corner, lower corner. And then there's also an arm that is always waving on the right side of your screen, which is always, when you click on that arm, it's always going to tell you every piece of information that you might be stuck with. So this is the greatest like support, like coaching, like mentorship. There's an academy. If you go to your resources or stuff, you get academy, you can get to do some courses before you even use the crypto hopper. And then you can pay for the certificate. There's a certificate that you get if you pay around $20 or so, and then you can show that you are fully qualified to use the crypto hopper because you've done all the classes. Like there's just videos showing you everything. So once you start using your crypto hopper, you probably want to start trying out your free 7-day trial, so you'll be exposed to paper trading, which is like they'll be giving you some virtual funds, which is not real money, but they'll be giving like some simulated situation where it's like your hopper is connected already to a specific exchange. Depending on which you choose, you go and configure yourself, and then you can choose the exchange. And then it's going to behave as if it's connected to those exchange without the API keys, obviously. So it's going to, they're going to show as if you have some funds, which you want. But for 7 days, you can trade with those funds, and then you can change your setting and see how they work and everything. So you get some pre-exposure. So newbies also have access to signalers in the marketplace. So, and there's a ready-made template loaded with expert trading strategies at the marketplace. So at the marketplace, you can go there and you can buy strategies, and you can also subscribe to signalers. And then strategies are just trading strategies that are just loaded into the template that you just purchase, or you buy for free, some are free, you just subscribe to it. And then it's going to trade, the bot is going to trade according to those strategies. And then they're going to place trades and close trade according to the strategy directly. So you won't even have to do anything. So there's an easy to use interface, and also there's easy, it's easy to configure. It could be a bit confusing at the beginning, but once you get the hang of things, you see that it's not that hard. So I'm also learning, and I'm also allowing people to share with me if there's any other ideas and tips that maybe they have on the helper. Maybe they've been trying it out, or you're still new to it, or want to add that you've tried this or anything. So please send us through. So once configured, connect to an exchange account using API keys. So if you are trading on a real account, or you already done with your 7-day trial and you want to start putting like real money and start trading for real, which you definitely gonna be doing, because after you send the trial of the offer, you can already see that it's making money. So you could be making like around 1% per day or less, but depending on the day in the markets. So, and you can even make more when the markets are like really bullish and stuff. So, and going high. So, would it be the trading stop loss which we're gonna go to get to? So, what is automatic trading? I'm gonna be quick on this one. I don't want this video to be very long. The latest and greatest innovation in e-trading. It's not very latest right now, but it's still latest to some people. But this was created in 2017, as I said. So it's still new to some people. Some people it's very, very old school, because there's even competition now. I mean, as saying that this company has been improving ever since they created this bot. And since people are supporting the bot, so they kept improving themselves, and the bot is now perfectly functional. There is other bots on the market. Some I've just received some bad news about, and some, you know, because they just they're not really using the same system as this one is doing. Like this one, you connect to an exchange and exchange trade on the exchange. Other bots, I'm not so sure. Maybe they, I don't know. But this one, the API keys, they connect via Swifty, and it's been around 2017, and 2020 is just I just learned about it, because I think it's been about 3 to 4 months now on this bot. Yeah. And yeah, it's been quite a good journey. So it allows you, okay, so it allows traders to apply, automation trading allows a trader to apply their personal trading strategy without having a bot to implement them. And then, so it means that they would be as if they were the ones that are trading, but they would take those strategies and program them on the robots to implement them while they are away from the from the market, so, or from their computer or from their devices. Yeah. So it allows you to trade 24/7, 365 days a year. So humans can never ever trade as much, because it's a robot. It doesn't really get tired. It doesn't have maybe to go and do things like we have to. Yeah. So this will be trading 24/7, like 365 days a year. If you keep paying your subscription and you are good, it's going to be paying non-stop. Yeah, so you can be just seeing and looking at your trades, how they are doing and stuff. And it's data driven. It uses pure analysis to drive its trading strategic decisions. So it's not affected by the news, by the whole commotion and the noise. So this is just pure analysis on the charts and placing and making decisions on those findings that the strategies would allow. I mean, then the charts would be displayed. So trades are available coins simultaneously, keeping track of their exact prices, meaning that it's not like a human being who would be. You can't trade all the coins if you're a human being. You can't even trade around 6 or 8 or 10 at a time. You know, 20 at a time. This can be trading all coins simultaneously, and then keeping watch of all the coins that it's trading. And every exact price, so you could be trading more than 20, sometimes 25 trades open. If there's bags, most of the time, but they'll be tracking every coin. So humans can't do this. So there's always pros and cons about bots. So I'm not gonna go into the bots. I'm just highlighting the good stuff, because you already know that there's always a risk in trading. So I'm not gonna give it a disclaimer on this video. But you can see the disclaimer in most of the videos on this channel. So selling, this one will also be selling as soon as the target gets, I mean, these coins are hitting the profit, so the target profit. So it knows exactly how each coin, how each coin is performing, and it knows when to sell because this coin is now hitting the target profit. The humans analyze less coins at a time. So signals are also responded to as they come in, because this is an automatic system. So for a human being, maybe you receive a signal, but you may be away from your devices, or you set up a strategy maybe to do it for you. So that is fine as well. But you can't set like so many strategies and so many coins. So it's a bot. You build a bot. So this is exactly what you're doing here. So you can build a bot. This is how you're building one. So this is a bot that you are building to trade for you. So this is the tips that I'm going to be giving you. You have opened, maybe you're going to the settings now, and you find that maybe you're still new, but this is just some features and tips that I'm going to be giving on how to set your hopper if the markets are bullish. So this is the, if Bitcoin and other markets like Ethereum and so on, most of the markets are affected by the movement of Bitcoin. So if Bitcoin is rising, most of them is rising, you know, so even though it's not doing the same thing, but there will be a huge connection. So most of the time when the market moves, they move in the almost the same direction as Bitcoin. So it's the largest one and controls most of them. So you would want to set your trading stop loss. Okay. Before I go into how to set the trading stop loss. What is the strategy, or how does the trading? What is the trading stop loss, and how does it help you? So a trading stop loss is a strategy that allows you to plan the upward trend of the market. So if the market is trading upward, so the stop loss will also go up with the trade. So the stop loss will not remain at the bottom where you put it. So it's going to trail with the market as well. So when it's going up though, when it's going down, it's another case. So if you are, the markets are bullish and they are going up and you see that the prices are good, so you go to your hopper, so you go to your settings, and then you go to your trading stop loss. And then you turn on, use trading stop loss only. And then you set your profit percentage, or your percentage of profit, at 10% or higher, if you like. It depends on how you see the markets to be. But most of the time, this gets ignored because of the trading stop loss. So the trading stop loss could drive the profits even higher, and then sell at a very higher point. Because it remains the same percentage even if the profits go up very higher than 10%. To explain this, if you still don't get this, we'll still, I don't know, it's gonna take time for you to get it, but you'll get it sometime soon. But it's more like if the graph is going high and then it drops at this, and then it goes higher again, and then it drops and then goes higher again. So the set stop loss will also be going trading up with the actual market price. So as soon as it goes down more than the actual percentage that is set for, it's going to close. But if it bounces back just before it touches the 21, the percentage is still going to trade up with it until it reaches maximum profit. So the trailing arm percentage, you want to set it at 3-5%. So this is how the arm, the trading arm, you set the trading arm to move. So if it's like 3-5%, then you know that you don't want to lose more than that. So you set your trading stop loss, which should be at the highest, at the first one you come to before you even get to turn on. And will be trading stop loss to 1.5%. You can also do your own calculations, but if it's a bull market, you can go higher. Some people get aggressive and do higher than this. And yeah, but this could be safer because I've been trying this myself. I've been seeing them from a couple of courses, I said, a couple of people, and I've been trying to go down. So if the markets are bearish, then they are just not producing much profits. They are like going a little downish. So you turn off your trading stop loss, and but you still turn on your trading stop loss on. So you don't see your trading stop loss here. So you set your percentage profits at 1.2 or low. Or low enough to make profit after fees. So you set your percentage profit 1.2% or lower. Right, so you don't want to make it that high. So remember here we put the 10% because the market should be going high up. But here you don't want to lose because the fees are on a cover, I won't get the trade going so much against you. So in the scale markets, when they are not really moving in any direction, you set your percentage profit to 5%, and then you check your trading stop loss arm to 1.5%, not 3%, and then your trading stop loss at 0.3%, and then you send off your use the trading stop loss on, because now the market has just. So, percentage by amount, what is the percentage by amount? Some people have been asking me that, so what is the percentage by amount, or how do you work that out? So, the percentage by amount means to you that you have to find out how many trades your boss is doing per day, and then you use that and factor it into your trading, I mean your total balance, and then you get your percentage by amount. So if you, for example, like here, you're doing, your boss is doing 5 trades per day, then your percentage by amount should be around 20%, meaning that that is going to compound all of your balance. So 100% of, if five trades, 20% of it, 20% each at least, so then you know that you expose all your requirements to trades. But remember again, before you set this like this, you might have coins that are begging, you might have also less funds in your account to carry those percentage, that much percentage. So you also would maybe not want to expose your whole portfolio or your whole balance to the trade. So you have to set the percentage according to how much you want to expose. So the minimum Bitcoin per order. So this is the minimum trade amount should the bot not be able to make the trade at the percentage by amount. So let's say, for example, you don't have maybe enough funds to place at 20% per trade, because you should have, I mean, if you were trade, you calculated that you do 5 trades a day and you put at 20%, but then you have maybe some trades that are going on that are maybe not, they're still big, and maybe you're still going down on charges. You have each other's, like, you have some charges and so on. But then you the trade will not go through. But then if you set this minimum BTC per order, it's going to help to know how much can be used if you don't have enough money. So you can use so you select it, then if there's not enough to place at 20%, you select it or percentage by amount, the boss uses numbers to make trades. So the number we'll be putting here is the percentage of like of that minimum per order. So you wanna calculate how much you have and how much you wanna use to trade. Right, so we move to the next feature, which is very great. It's at the bottom of the configuration. It's DCA. TCA. H TCA, explaining TCA will be very difficult, but I'll just highlight it through. It's just buying back that which you have lost, and then buying more coins when the price of that coin you bought it goes down. So if maybe you bought like 10 units of 100 of a coin, let's say 100 Satoshi, and then the price goes down to 90, and then you buy 10 more, and then you have more like 1,900 Satoshi. And then you, if you calculate those two buys, you would have like 20 Satoshis, I mean 20 units of Satoshi, and then you get like 1,900 Satoshi. So if you divide that 1,900 by 20, it gives you 95, which means that you have lost half of what you actually lost. So it's called total cost averaging. It's very useful. It makes your losses less, and you should always make this. If you are turning on your hopper, you should always have this setting on. At this setting that I'm going to give you, or if you have configured better configuration, you can share. We can see. I mean, we can maybe try them out ourselves. But so the DCA open time will be 5 minutes. That would be the open time after you wanna open in order to do that DCA, because you might find that the market there's no sell there. So you find that particular coin is not being sold, so you can wait with the order open for 5 minutes. So the retries would be 3 times. So if it doesn't work the first time, another time, 3 times, 3 tries. And then the percentage trigger will be 5%. So if your trade is going low, but about 5% low, it's like your stop loss like sort of thing. So it's gonna be triggered as soon as your trade goes lower, it's 5%. So you should turn on DCA buy immediately on your hopper, and you should also, your order size should be a double, not a triple down. So a double down. Right, so we reach the end of this one. You should take care of yourself and keep hoping.